the undemocratic measures that this government is carrying out.
Fight for us!
No tunnel,
no way!
We're gonna fight it all the way!
Let's go back to Melbourne now. Police and protesters are facing off for another day over the east-west tunnel. Officers were in place early this morning, forcing the demonstrators to move to another of the test drilling sites for the project. It followed violent clashes on the picket line yesterday. And protester Mel Gregson joins me now from the picket line in Melbourne. Mel, good morning.
Good morning, Sam.
Why did things get out of control yesterday?
Community members and residents from the local area are very frustrated about the fact that there's been a huge police deployment every morning this week for the government to continue their test drilling for the much hated and controversial East West Link project.
And if you think you can come in here with your wrecking balls and your corporate criminals and destroy people's homes and livelihoods and futures and put a north-south divide in Yarra, you've got another thing coming. Because we're going to stop this tunnel. And we're going to build a new society.
I will bring the needs and aspirations of working class people to every table I sit at.
The first socialist elected to the city office in Seattle in generations.
There will be no backroom deals with corporations or their political servants. There will be no rotten sellouts of the people I represent.
Look at the amount of money and the number of foot soldiers the labor movement provides for every election for the Democratic Party. And what have we got out of it? We've got a long-term assault on labor unions.
We have a supermajority in Seattle. 70% of Seattle wants a strong 15. That's the supermajority we care about.
Capitalism cannot survive ever, even today, without an ongoing massive exploitation globally.
Yes, it's true that genuinely small businesses are getting wiped out. But that is not because workers are being paid too much. That's because that's in the nature of capitalist system to crush small businesses and give all the impact expect business.
15 was not won, as we've often heard, at the bargaining table. It was not the result of the generosity of corporations or their Democratic Party representatives in government. What was voted on in the city council, or what will be voted on, is a reflection of what workers and the labor movement have won on the streets. 15 in Seattle is just a beginning. We have an entire world to win. Solidarity.
Great inspiration for us. It's a great inspiration for
registered as asylum seekers, working basic rights. There is no way to guarantee that the rest of the workers in Israel would receive their rights too. Thank you very much.
Thank you so much.
Många har dragit slutsatser som lutar åt vänster. För den feministiska rörelsen mindre enad och saknar ännu samma politiska slagkraft.
There's two divisions in politics. There's the first division, Labour, Liberal, Democrats, Tories, UKIP, an overlapping agenda when it comes to austerity. There's a second division, and TUSC, the party of which I'm the national chair, is the sixth largest party in the country when it comes to the council elections, and the only one with an absolute policy against austerity and against all the effects on local people's services.
We're here this morning to highlight to Wilton Forest that the rents in the borough are far too high, people just can't afford it, wages are being driven down, jobs are being cut.
We haven't got any political representatives in the main political parties that actually stand against cuts and stand up for ordinary people. And that's why I'm also supporting and standing on the trade union and socialist coalition list.
So the people are aware, the current budget proposals for the council will be made on February the 13th, and are proposing £20 million worth of cuts to services in the city, which will mean the loss of over 300 jobs. It'll mean cuts to all sorts of services, for the homeless, to support families, to libraries, to youth services.
Por favor, para registro.
Sí, mi nombre es Johan Rivas, yo soy miembro de la Organización Socialismo Revolucionario, que es parte del Consejo Popular Revolucionario. Esto queremos aprovecharlo también para que expresar en nombre del CPR, del Consejo Popular Revolucionario, nuestro rechazo a la campaña de criminalización de las luchas populares, de la lucha de los trabajadores. Estamos en contra de cualquier mecanismo de represión, de acoso, de criminalización de la protesta, en este caso de los trabajadores y los sectores populares.
Mein Name ist Sebastian Kugler, ich bin Aktivist der Sozialistischen Linkspartei, ich war selber 2 Jahre Schulsprecher, habe dort die Schulstreiks von 2009 mitorganisiert, damals gegen die 2 Stunden Mehrarbeit für Lehrerinnen und Lehrer, gegen die Abschaffung der schulautonomen Tage. Wir waren damals erfolgreich 2009, es gibt keinen Grund, warum wir nicht diesmal 2013 auch erfolgreich sein sollten.
Now, comrades, there are many workers who have said to us, is the Workers' and Socialist Party just a party for mine workers? And we are saying no, it is a party for the entire working class.
There's no need for anyone, white, foreign or not, to try and destabilize the economy. That's happening all on its own because of the massive contradiction that exists between the capitalists' haves and the working class have-nots.
Leave says WASP tries to be active all over the country.
History is crying out for a working class alternative in South Africa as across the world.
Commission is an undemocratic cabal. It represents the interests of bankers, of big business, of bondholders, and that's who they're driving. And they're destroying Europe. They're destroying the lives of people, the humanitarian catastrophe. You see in Greece, people moving to the countryside because they can't get access to food. In the city, people in this country fainting, kids fainting in schools because they don't have food, people sleeping in cars, people sleeping in vans, because Europe is being run in the interests of the 1%.